Mrs. M. Priyadarshini, ME MBA, is doing PhD, is currently working as teaching fellow in the department of IST, Anna University, Chennai. She completed a master's in software engineering from Anna University. She has about 10 years of experience in handling courses for UG and PG. She was serving as technical evangelist for corporate over 4 years in Java Enterprise Technologies, Software Engineering, Databases, OOAD and Design Patterns. She is proficient in handling IT projects as well into concept development for enterprises. She is doing a research in the area of web services security. Her other areas of interest include software engineering, OOAD, databases, enterprise technologies and service-oriented architecture. She holds many journal publications and conference proceedings in her research area.
Welcome to UGC lecture series in Computer Science Java. So far in your previous session, we have been discussing about various concepts available in Java, and also we have seen various packages that is available in Java. So all Java APIs, and using that, now we are going to see how your applications are generated. So previously in two of your sessions, we have been discussing about how to develop a small Java application with what are all the concepts that already you have learnt. Whereas here we are going to concentrate on few concepts such as how to create a menu and how event handling is done, and then we are going to see a small GUI based as well as database programming application, and we'll have a look on how this is to be executed and how you are trying to build and develop your pure Java application. And here we are just going to look at standalone application. So clearly we have discussed about different types of applications in Java. So normally Java has standalone applications. Java can be used in order to develop applets, which is a web-based application. So here we will have a look on a standalone application. So we are not going to use applets, whereas we are going to use frames, and we are going to see how your components are organized on your frames, and then how menus are organized and how you are trying to handle your events. We will have a sample requirements and proceed with it. We have a sample requirement. So this requirement speaks about customer management system. So here we have a very short description about your requirements. So here, create a Java application to create a customer management system with the following options. So here we have three options. One is add customer with details such as ID, name and address, and then view customer details on selection of the customer ID. Once customer is added, the application need to be directed to your main menu. So here we have only three requirements that has been stated. One is we are trying to add the customer details. So this option add should have a GUI in which you need to have all the details that is specified in your requirement, such as your ID, name and address. So once the GUI is created, next you need to have another GUI which is going to view the customer details. So wherein there is an option that view customer details on selection of the customer ID. So it means that there should be a list of customers, and from that list of customer we try to choose one of the customer, and on choosing that particular customer, the details of that customer should be displayed on your GUI. So your GUI should have a provision such as a combo box in which you have a list of your customer IDs being displayed. So before you generate your GUI, your combo box should be loaded with the data that is taken from your database. So that is the list of available customers. So on selection of that customer, we will be able to see the customer details of that corresponding customer. Once we have a view of the customer, after we view the customer, we should be able to move to your main menu, as well as once you add a customer, you should be able to move to your main menu. So we need to create a GUI in which you have a menu. In that menu we have two options. One is add the customer and view the customer. So first we have to organize your application such way that we have various frames. One frame or one GUI is used in order to add the customer detail, and another GUI which is used in order to view the customer details, and then both should be organized and navigated from a main menu. For the implementation, we have three Java classes that has been created. One is add frames, inherited frame in which you are going to add the customer, and view frame. Here we have inherited a frame which is going to be used for viewing the customer details. And your CMS is your main program from where we are trying to have a menu. This menu is, this is again a frame. So in this frame we have created a menu. This frame is going to navigate you between your add frame and the view frame. So we can have a look on how your components are organized in each of these frames. Import java.awt, so we have used awt, and then java.awt.event.star. So here we have used all the events that is available in awt. So and then import javax.swing. So here you can notice that we have also imported few swing components. We are going to use few of the awt components, and the events are going to be from your awt. So swing package doesn't have any event handling mechanism as such. We don't have events, we don't have listeners in the swing package, whereas all the listeners and all your events are available in the awt package. So you can also use a combination of your swing components as well as the awt components. So you can see here we have created a class CMS which is going to extend JFrame. So you know that J prefix means it is from swing, implements the action listener. So action listener is from AWT, and then I am creating a menu bar, and then I am creating a menu, and then I am creating two menu items. So these two menu items are going to be used in order to navigate you to your add menu, add frame, as well as your view frame. So and then here is the constructor. So you know that in constructor you need to load all the components. So we are calling base class. Base class is nothing but your JFrame, and you are creating an instance. So we have declared the menu bar. Here we are creating an instance of the menu bar, and then I am creating one menu here, new menu customer. So and then I am creating two menu items, one is add, another one is edit. And then I am on this menu, I am adding these two menu items. So again your menu is added onto menu bar, and then now I am calling the method set menu bar of the frame, and then I am giving my menu bar as the parameter. So now this menu bar is associated with the frame, with your current frame. So you can notice that we have called method directly inside the constructor of the frame. So it means that for this particular frame your menu bar will be associated with. So now I am adding the action listener. So you know this is for event handling mechanism. So in this event handling mechanism I am trying to handle the events that is raised by both these menu items. One is my add customer menu item, next one is view customer menu item. So I am adding the action listener, and then I am specifying that as this. You know what is the reason that we are going, that we are using the keyword this here? It means that the listener methods, the methods which need to be executed by listening to a particular event, is available within this particular CMS frame itself. So your CMS frame implements all the methods that are to be listened. So here you know your menu item is going to be listened by action listener. Action listener is going to handle your action event, and the method which is available is action perform method. So I am setting the size for my frame, and then I am setting the default close operation. So this is activating your close button on the menu. So you know that whenever I create any GUI component, it is associated to your event provided you have written the action listener. Whereas here we are not writing the action listener for the window, that is your CMS frame. For that J frame I am not writing any window listener. So if I write window listener, only on close of that particular close button the window will get closed. Unless otherwise I write that particular window listener, I will not be able to close my window. So this is another mechanism through which I can make my particular application close. So set default close operation method, I am passing jframe.exit on close method. So here I have called show method, so my frame will be displayed to the customer. So in my main I am creating a new instance of customer management system. So this will make you to execute your Java application. On the execution you will be displayed with the CMS frame, that is customer management system frame. In that frame we have added a menu bar, we have added two menu items, and on those menu items we have written an event handling mechanism. That event handling mechanism is going to invoke two other frames. So now you can see that this is the action listener, that is written action perform method. So I am getting the source, I am getting whether my menu item that is clicked, that is AE dot action event dot get source is equal to add customer menu item. If it is add customer menu item, I create an instance of the add frame by passing the title add customer, and then I am disposing this current frame, which is my current frame. My current frame is my CMS frame. So I am currently in CMS frame. I am trying to click the menu item add, and on click of the menu item add customer menu item. So add customer add frame will be displayed, and my CMS frame has to be disposed. So there is difference between hide and dispose. Whenever I try to hide, that will be hidden and it will be available in the memory. Whenever I call dispose, automatically the frame object will be disposed, and once it has to be again created, I have to create it using the constructor. If it is hidden, then I can call show method and show that particular frame. So then next option, I am checking whether my source is view customer menu item. So in that case, I am creating a new instance of the view frame, and then I am calling the dispose method. So this dot dispose is nothing but I am disposing the CMS. First, I am trying to make the customer view the add menu item or my customer menu item, and then I am trying to dispose the CMS at the back end. So here you can see the program for add frame. So in this add frame, the functionality that we need to do is we need to have a GUI. In the GUI, we need to have all the details that are specified in the requirements. On click of that particular add or save, your data has to be updated in the database. So you can see here, class add frame extends JFrame implements action listener. So I am having label for customer number, then for customer name, and then for customer address. Again, I am having three text fields which is going to receive the input from the user for customer number and my customer name and customer address, and then I have a button, save button, and then I have two panels here. So it means that your GUI, your frame, is going to be split into two different panels. So one is your input panel and the other one is operation OPER panel. So here you can see this is the constructor. I am trying to call the base class, that is JFrames constructor. I am creating an instance of customer number label, customer name label, and I am creating instances of that, and then text fields I am creating, whereas address I have specified it as text area. And then in input panel, so for this input panel, I am creating a new panel with a grid layout of these components. So I have three labels and three text boxes, so three rows and two columns, and then I specify the horizontal and vertical spacing to be 25 and 25. So I am adding all these components, that is my customer number, name, address, labels and text fields. And once I add it, then I create an instance of the save button. On creation of the instance of the save button, I am trying to add the action listener to the button, because on click of this particular button only, you are going to save your customer details in the database. So you can see here, save button, I am adding that, and then I am creating an instance of the operation panel in which I am using flow layout. So operation panel dot add save button. So in this, we have only one button to be added, so that is your save button. So now set layout method. So I am calling set layout method for the add frame. So here we have created two panels. One is my input panel. Input panel uses grid layout. My operation panel uses flow layout. And then now I am currently setting the layout for my frame, that is my GUI add frame. So that add frame is your grid layout in which you have two rows and one column. So one row is for input panel and the other row is for operation panel. So I am adding input panel and operation panel. I am setting the size, and then I am trying to add the window listener, and here I am calling new window closer. So this window closer is an adapter. So we'll anyway see that what is window closer, and then I call the show method. So here we come to the action performed method. This is for your add button, that is your save button. So here I am trying to create a JDBC connectivity. So I am using JDBC ODBC driver. This is type one type of driver. So driver has been registered. That then I am getting the connection from the driver using customer DSN. So this is the ODBC data source that is created in your client system with no username and password. Here we have not specified username password. And then I call get connection method and get the connection object. Once I get the connection object, then I create a statement from that of the connection object in order to execute my insert statement. So, this is done inside my action performed method. Of action perform method is going to, because here we have only one button and I have not used if statement in order to check from which source this particular event has been raised. So, now we will have a short break and then we will proceed with how to have your further development of this particular program. So, welcome after the break. So, we will try to continue with the program that we are discussing upon. So, we are in add frame. So, we have created the frame and we have included all the elements in the frame, and also we have come into the event handling mechanism, that is your action perform method. So, in the action perform method, initially I have created the connection, I have created a statement object. Now, I am preparing my query. So, you can see that insert into customer values, from my text box customer number I am extracting the customer number value, and then from the text box customer name I am extracting the customer name value, and then I am trying to extract the address value. So, all these values are to be inserted in inside this particular table. So, now I have constructed a query string. So, this query string is passed as parameter to my execute update method. So, while we have discussing about statement object, we have studied clearly about state execute update method. This is normally used in order to execute your DDL and your DDL or your DML queries. So, after I execute this, so the data that is available in all these text boxes get inserted inside the database. I am closing my connection and then I am handling the exception. So, here you can see that inside your add frame, I am trying to create the customer management system and then I am disposing this particular add frame. So, now your add frame Java program is used in order to insert the customer data inside your database. So, that is it's going to, so we have used only statement and not prepared statement. Very well, you can go in for using prepared statement also. So, next is view frame. So, this is the frame which is instantiated when you click the option edit in your menu. So, you can see the same event handling mechanism, and you can see what is the window closer. So, there we have instantiated this particular window closer. So, this window closer is nothing but your window adapter class, which has only one method, that is window closing method. So, the window closer is going to just create an instance of your CMS and it will exit from your system. So, now this window closer has been called from all the other programs. So, whenever I am trying to close the window, automatically instead of writing all the methods of your window listener, we can just have a window closer, which is an adapter. We can use only one particular method which we are trying to invoke. We have a view frame where we have labels and your choice box. So, here this view frame is used in order to view the customer details. So, here already I told you that there should be some combo box which should be filled in with all the customer numbers that is already available in the database. So, we have labels, customer number, name and address. So, we have a choice instead of text field. So, and then text field for name and address. So, and then we have the button which is your close button, and then panel, input panel and operation panel, as such we have seen in your previous add frame. So, here we have a connection and we have a statement. So, here we have view frame where this calls the base class constructor, and then we are trying to create a database connectivity and your statement is getting created. So, the same process what we have done in your add frame, here it is used to generate the values from your database and then to generate the values, whereas in your previous add frame it is used to insert value. So, this here you are going to query. So, you can see here we have customer number label and then customer name and then customer address, these are labels, whereas here you can see choice. So, this choice need to be filled, the CNO choice need to be filled with the data from the database. So, I am creating two text fields. Now, I am having a result set in which I select only the customer IDs from the customer table. all the customer IDs will be generated. Now my choice box, that is my combo box, is filled with the items that is taken from the database. So rs.getString(1) is going to return only the customer IDs, because we have only one field that is generated from your customer table. So that is your getString(1) will return you with the customer IDs. And then I am trying to create the input panel, as such I have created in my previous add frame. So 3x2, so 3 rows and 2 columns, and then which is filled with the labels and your text boxes as well as your choice. And then here I am trying to add the item listener, whereas in your previous add frame we have seen action listener. Here on choosing a particular item on my choice, automatically the data should be taken for retrieve from the database. So the customer name and address belonging to that particular customer ID is retrieved from the database and it is fetched to the corresponding text boxes. So you can see here we have close button. As a button we have only close, whereas whenever I choose my item in the choice box, automatically this item listener will be listened to. And I am adding the panel for my operation, that is my flow layout, and I am having only one button, close button. So setting the layout to be grid layout, the same process, as so your GUI will look like your ad. Only difference you will have is there, instead of having a text field for customer number, here we have a choice. So you can see we have an exception handling mechanism, yes, same set size. I am setting the size of the frame, and then I am adding windows listener, new window closer. So on closing this particular view frame, automatically my customer management system frame will get displayed. The method item state change. So this is the method that is available in your item listener interface. So item event. So the query you can notice, select start from customer, where customer ID is equal to my choice dot get selected item. So whenever user is selecting a particular item in the choice, this particular item listener will be activated, and then your item listener will be available with your item event, and then item state change method will be invoked. So here whatever the item that I have selected, so this will be the customer number. I have used select star, so all the details of the customer will be generated, and then I am using only two details, that is my name and address, which should be put in the name text field and then your address text field. So I am calling the set text method in order to set the text values. So here you can see action perform method, this is only for close. So connection, I am trying to close the connection, and then I am going to exit. I am going to invoke the customer management system dot dispose. So here you can see that I am trying to do the same mechanism in my close button as well as in the close button of my frame, that is my view frame. So both should do the same process. So now you can see that as an output of this particular program, you will be displayed with the menu. So this is what is your CMS frame, and inside that we have a menu, and then under that menu we have two items, add and edit. So on click of add, you will be displayed with this GUI. This is your add frame. So inside your add frame, you will be given with two text boxes and one text area. So I can fill in all the details, and on click of this and automatically the data that is given by the user in these corresponding text boxes and text area will be saved in your database. And you can see on view customer, I choose a particular customer ID. So this customer ID is populated from your database. So all the available customer IDs will be loaded on this particular choice. So on select of a particular item, the database connectivity will be established, and the address and the name corresponding to this particular customer will be generated, and it will be set to these text boxes and this text area. And so on close of this, I will be closing my particular view frame, and then I will move on to my CMS. So I can use add and view frame interchangeably. So once we have completed with this development, so later on if you are trying to change your requirement, so my requirements is changed in such a way that whenever I choose one particular customer, I get the details of the customer, whereas if I have to view all the customer list of customers available, so in that case I can add one more option in my particular menu and then include the option as such. The requirement changes, list of all customers should be displayed along with the other options. So I have created a list frame.java file. So in this file you can see that we have the same input statements, AWTU, your swing, your IO, and then SQL. So here you can see public class list frame extends J frame, and then I have included J table. So we have already seen what is J table and how the data could be loaded on your J table. So we have container, and then here I have names, here string name, customer ID, customer name and customer address. So this is going to act as a header, and then data, I need to fill this data with the data that is taken from my database. So public list frame, so I am calling the base class constructor, and then I am initializing I and j values, you can see that. So I am establishing a database connectivity, the same process, and then I am creating a statement. So here result set statement dot execute query select star from customer. So here we need to see list of customers. So all the customers, we don't have any conditions based on which the customer need to be selected. So since it's all the customer, I have just given select star from customer, and then I am trying to fetch the values from the result set and they load it onto data. So I will be filled with 0, 1, 2, 3. So this I represent the row. So for each and every row in the result set, I increment my I value. So data of 0 comma 0 will be rs dot get string of 1. This is my first customer number, name and address. So second, whenever my results, next time my result set dot next is called, next row will be fetched. So similarly, I fill in with all the rows that is available till I ensure that my rs dot next becomes false. Till that, I load all the values in my data. That is the array, two dimensional array. Here you can see J table. So in this J table, I am having my data and name. So my container, get content pane, you know that in your J frame, you cannot directly add the components. You can use get content pane and add the components. I am setting the background, and then I am creating a scroll pane, because in my table, I may have n number of rows, and then if at all I want to display n number of rows, that data need to be loaded on a scroll pane. So I am creating horizontal scroll bar, vertical scroll bar. I am adding my particular scroll bar in the center on my content pane. So and then I am adding the listener, and then I am showing the particular frame. So you can see here this J table is loaded with the data already. So whenever I load the J table, automatically my data will get displayed on the particular frame. Frame will be loaded with my scroll pane. Scroll pane will be loaded with the J table with the query, that is the data that is fetched from the query, all the customers. So you can see here add, edit and view all. So this is the option that is newly added. We have customer management system output. So here you have customer ID and your name and address. So this is loaded on a scroll pane, and this scroll pane is loaded on a frame, that is your list frame. So we have list frame. In this list frame, we have created a scroll pane. On the scroll pane, we have created the J table. So J table is loaded with, so this is your names and this is your data. So as a summary, in today's session we have discussed about how to create, or you can say how to design and develop an application using your menus, and how to incorporate the event handling mechanism, and how to have an GUI based program which involves database connectivity. So from this session we will be able to answer questions such as how menus are created, what is a window adapter, how to add listener to the components, and then how to add JDBC data into your choice component, and which event is listened to access the selected item in the choice, and so on. So in your forthcoming sessions, we are going to see about how object-oriented concepts is implemented in Java. So how a Java program could be written with object-oriented concepts, without object-oriented concepts, and how to package a Java application, and so on. Thank you.